Tech is a word that, if misused, can cause unreasonable fear or unjustified acceptance that the fight is over, leading to unnecessary suffering and death.
Life pretty much froze after this day.
COVID-19.
Our world turned upside down.
Coronaviruses are a big family of enveloped, non-segmented, single-stranded, positive-sense RNA viruses that circulate among animals, including cats, bats, and camels. Coronaviruses derive their name from the electron microscopic image, which resembles a crown or corona. On December 30th, 2019, a cluster of patients with pneumonia of unknown etiology was observed in Wuhan, China, and reported to the World Health Organization's China Bureau in Beijing. The virus was initially referred to as novel coronavirus 2019 by the World Health Organization, but on February 11, 2020, was given the official name SARS-CoV-2 by the International Committee of Taxonomy on Viruses. The disease caused by this SARS-CoV-2 virus is then known as Coronavirus Disease 2019, or otherwise known as COVID-19.
The COVID-19 outbreak is a disruptive force that has taken the world by storm and has spread to every continent on Earth except Antarctica. As of May 2021, COVID-19 has spread to 170 million people and has claimed 3.5 million lives globally. As the pandemic reshapes our world, it is also accelerating the digital landscape by several years. This has led to a surge in information online. Amid the uncertainty, many have fallen into the traps of fake news, exploiting public fear and uncertainty around the coronavirus pandemic. This includes misinformation and disinformation.
An infodemic is a superabundance of information both online and offline. It includes deliberate attempts to spread fraudulent information that undermines public health responses and advance alternative agendas of groups and individuals. Mis- and disinformation can be harmful to people's physical health and mental health. It increases stigmatization, threatens precious health gains, and leads to poor observance of public health measures, thus reducing their effectiveness and endangering countries' ability to stop the pandemic. Misinformation costs lives. Without the appropriate trust in correct information, diagnostic tests go unexploited, effective vaccines will never meet their targets, and the virus will unfortunately continue to thrive. Now, we need to deal with an epidemic, but the burning question is how?
The Trace Together is a digital system that is implemented by the government to enhance Singapore's effort to mitigate the spread of COVID-19 through the community-driven contact tracing. This system consists of an app and a token for those who don't use a smartphone. Both the app and the token work by exchanging short-distance Bluetooth signals between other nearby Trace Together devices. And as of May 17, 2021, the government has announced that the Trace Together will be made mandatory for checking in to various venues and events. The mandated use of Trace Together enables contact tracers to quickly identify and isolate close contacts of COVID-19 cases, breaking the transmission chains and preventing community outbreaks.
So we want to capitalize on the fact that it's been made mandatory and include two new functions, SafeNews and SafeHealth. These two functions will help keep the public fake news free as well as health literate. SafeNews will be a feature on the app where users can upload news that they want to check the credibility of. This will be done through machine learning, which I'll detail later. They will then receive a fake or real diagnosis. They will also be updated about fake news that is in circulation, whether it's via messaging platforms or social media. These updates will actually be from the news uploaded by users of the Trace Together app. Once again, because Trace Together is mandatory for all people in Singapore to carry, the other feature that we would like to add is something called SafeHealth. SafeHealth will feature blog-like posts aimed at increasing health literacy among users. The features that we want to add to Trace Together sound rather simple, and the great thing is that they are. Using machine learning to identify fake news is not an easy task to accomplish, though, and the model will have to be refined through research and development. I'm going to show you a rough plan of essentially a decision tree classifier, which will segment the type of news received and determine what kind of machine learning model will be used to determine whether it's real or fake. The users will have the option of uploading either a URL or an image into the Safe News Checker. This is our first segmentation. So let us start with what happens when a URL is uploaded. The first classification will be what kind of website is the URL linked to. For simplicity, we'll have predetermined identifiers which will classify the URL into a video platform, social media platform, or a website. Now, let's say that the classifier decides that the media uploaded is a website. A second classification of whether the URL links to an accredited website, which are also predetermined, or not, occurs. If the URL does not link to an accredited website, that's when the real machine learning begins, and the hard part starts. A combination of linguistic analysis, which could be in the form of deep syntax analysis or semantic analysis based on support vector machines and Bayesian models, will be applied to determine whether the news is likely to be real or fake. as well as a support vector machine for anomaly detection applied to the structure of the website, which is obtained from the HTML of the website, or JavaScript. An interesting thing to take into account though, especially when looking into like linguistic analysis, is what is actually fake news? It's not about just misinformation that's created intentionally, it's also misinterpreted satire, conspiracy theories, rumors, the list goes on. And this is actually why linguistic analysis is such a powerful tool for determining whether news is fake or real. Now, let's say the URL uploaded was classified as a social media platform or a video sharing platform, and it is not included in the predetermined reliable sources. Then we'll combine the aforementioned linguistic analysis with a social network analysis approach, which will look at the poster's network behavior and analyze the data linked to the original news or content. Using anomaly detection again, we think that we will be able to use the social network to identify what media may be fake. So now let us take a look at what happens if an image is uploaded. First, we will use Google's Tesseract optical character recognition engine to pull out text data from the image. If the image does produce text data, then we can use linguistic analysis as we did before. If the image does not have text data or contains actual images on top of the text, we'll use a multi-level perceptron neural network powered to tell us whether the image is Photoshopped or not. Now, you may be saying, oh, wow, neural networks for image classification? You're gonna need a lot of data and a lot of computing power. But big data analytics will be essential to building all of these classification methods and will be employed to analyze all the trends in fake data that we are looking for. This is actually possible because fake news is not a new problem. We have lots of fake news. It's just more of a problem now, and it's become more dangerous with the onset of a global pandemic. Now, machine learning is an incredibly powerful tool, but what happens when it fails? Well, this is where, unfortunately, we have to bring in humans. After media is uploaded and passed through the machine learning model, it will be given a score based on how confident the appropriate model is with its classification. If this score is too low, a value that will have to be determined through research and development, the media will then be passed on to Protection for Online Falsehoods and Manipulation Act, or POFMA for short, officers which already employ agents that look for virtual fallacies. Speaking of POFMA, interestingly enough, we think that fake news that is intentionally created will be the hardest to identify because the creator will want it to seem real. The data gathered from TraceTogether will also be another avenue to gain insight into what fake news is circulating and where it's circulating. This will give greater security into whether media uploaded is a true positive or a true negative. We believe that the implementation of safe news and safe health will not be an arduous task because of the already existing infrastructure. The research and development that will go into the machine learning model will be the feature that will require the most time and resources. We have decided that it is appropriate to dedicate an overall timeline of 6 months to the expansion of TraceTogether. Research and development, which will include UX, UI design, and programming, as well as the building of the machine learning model, will take up to 3 months. Beta testing of the new and improved app will be allocated 1 month. Setup and implementation will be allocated 1 month, and another 1 month will be dedicated to evaluation of the extended features.
With these implementations to the TraceTogether app that is already mandatory for all Singaporeans, users will be able to verify and validate any news and information of various forms. Users will be able to stay updated to all TraceTogether verified and reliable health news to increase their health literacy. These features can be easily implemented via over-the-air updates. Furthermore, the impact can be actively monitored via app logins.
With a budget of $50,000, our budgeting plans are as follows. A substantial amount of our budget will be allocated to the research and development and operational costs of the application. We have allocated $20,000 to research and development, which includes the building of the machine learning model, as mentioned earlier. $25,000 will be allocated to the operational costs of the app, which includes maintenance costs like the iOS and Android updates. And the remaining $5,000 of our budget will be allocated to the application development. With a rapidly aging population, the elderly are among the least technologically savvy groups in the population, which puts them at the highest risk of being exposed to COVID-19 misinformation. To increase technology literacy among the elderly, the government has introduced various initiatives to further facilitate the use of technology by making it affordable and accessible. The Mobile Access for Seniors initiative is part of the Senior Go Digital program, and it provides subsidized smartphones and digital mobile plans. On top of that, various SG Digital Community Hubs are set up across the island where seniors are able to obtain one-on-one guidance on basic skills like digital government services and cybersecurity. Aside from basic digital skills, the SG Digital Community Hubs can help familiarize seniors with how to utilize the new Safe News and Safe Health features on the TraceTogether and prevent the spread of misinformation and improve health literacy.